Let's change this rear sprocket. Looks like we've got some lugs or tabs to move. Really? There's one. I don't know what torque these are supposed to be at. Out, do they? Right, I'm going to clean this, then come back. I've cleaned that up. I'm just going to smear a bit of this on to stop it rusting, as it says it's a rust inhibitor. So only a bit of oil. Stuff that cloth in there, it should stop them falling. Now I painted these red, and I don't know what they're called, to buy new ones. So if anybody knows the proper name for these, let me know, because I want to buy some new ones. On loose at the moment. Oops. Every time I've searched for those things I've painted red, I've been looking for rear sprocket nut locks, rear sprocket bolt locks, and I never seem to find them, so I don't know what they're called. I also don't know what the torque setting is. They weren't that tight when I took them off. So all I've done is placed those wheel nuts where they should be, put that on loose, I'll put it in there to keep it tight while I tighten it up. So I don't know what torque setting it was, but they weren't that tight, so I'll use my inbuilt torque setting. brain should be able to tell you when they're all about the same tightness. As long as it's not going to wobble loose, it should be okay. This is a half inch spanner I'm using, by the way. I don't know if it's a half inch or 13 millimetre, but this fits perfectly. Well, it did. I think this nut's a bit... Right, let's try and get them all set to the same tightness. Put them all here. Yes. I think they're all about the same. What I will do is put them so that they are flat against this locking thing. That one will be, that one will be, that one will be, that one will be. Get a hammer. I'm going to consider that done. So we've got a new cush drive rubber, new rear sprocket. As I said in the previous video, I'm going to leave the brake shoes as they are because I did buy new brake shoes, but they're no different to these really. So these have either fairly new or not had much use. Because when I put them in the drum and put the brakes on, they only go to the halfway wear limit before they're fully locked on. You know, about there they start to bind, and there it's like okay, so I shall leave them in. Oops. And the back wheel's done. I'll just give it a clean. Probably put some new grease in places before I put it on, because this is a bit dry in there. Yeah. That'll have new grease in it. Put some new grease in there. And in there, I'll repack it with grease before attaching it to the bike. But that job's done. Another simple and easy job. And cheap enough. So, until next time. Oh, and if you do know what they're called, let me know. Laters.